Yeah, no, I'm gonna put him here for now. He's definitely not deep tier.
What is up, YouTube? Marvello here. I hope you're having an awesome day. Today, we're gonna talk about everybody's favorite subject, tier lists. We decided to do a more recent one, an updated one. It's a very long video. We go into detail on every single character. And I share my thoughts, and we get a lot of people from the community that join in and share their thoughts. So I hope you enjoy the video. As always, if you like what you see, like, comment, subscribe. It helps the algorithm a lot. And enjoy the rest of the video. See ya.
All right, so let's start. Generally speaking, I feel like the meta right now is in kind of an interesting place in that there's, in my opinion, there's two clear winners on who the best characters in the game are. For sure. Okay? And we could talk about it from like, In the old days, let me see if I could find one. But like in the old days, the way they made tier lists were like based on matchups, right? They used to make it based on like matchup rating, and they would have spreadsheets, and it used to be like, see this shit? This is how they used to do tier lists. They would get like the best players of whatever character, and then they would ask them like what their fucking, thoughts on a given matchup are, and then they would just come up with a number. Yeah, like fucking Sagat versus Blanca is, 6-4 in Sagat's favor or whatever. And then they would add it up, and then clearly Sagat is the best character in the game. I want this tier list to be kind of like, kind of rational. So if somebody disagrees with me, I want them to speak up and I want to hear their truth. Okay? So right now, in the game, let's start with the best, right? Happy Chaos. Why is Happy Chaos good, right? And it's because... Okay, so Happy Chaos is amazing, really, in my opinion, because, like, what makes a character fucking good... What makes a character good is, like, consistent, like, damage and control of the neutral game. Okay? Happy Chaos, I don't think, loses neutral in any matchup, right? Like, by design, he controls neutral. So, therefore, he's, like, insanely consistent. And, like, if you're a good player and you're good at neutral, you're good at controlling neutral, you could take over a match, like, easily. So, every matchup, when you're fighting Happy Chaos, it's you versus... Happy Chaos in like a very one-dimensional way. Like it's not very much. How do I describe it? It's like you're playing Time Crisis. You're playing a one-player game that you're just waiting for a hopeful moment where they make a mistake or that they need to focus. They're literally doing whatever they want versus you the whole game. Eventually, you see like an opening, and then maybe you could do something about it. But yeah. Not only that, he has some of the best normals in the game. His 5K is really good. His far slash is really good. His 5D, for some reason, is harder to block than other 5Ds because of the startup animation. I don't know what it is about this. It's technically the same startup as, like, other uncharged 5Ds, but it fucking hits. I don't know what it is. It's fucking really, really good. His 2P is insanely good. It's really, really good. It doesn't... People can't crouch it. And then this button. This right here is the most insane button in the game. This is the best button in the game, in my opinion. If somebody disagrees, let me know. But this is the best button in the game, in my opinion. This button, the hurt box that it has... The hitbox that it has, how low it is, it's just fucking insane. It's so fast. And not to mention when we were talking about consistency, like if Chip hits you with a low, if a lot of characters hit you with a low, they just get 2K 2D, right? Or if any K normal, right? Like if I hit you with 5K, what do? I get like 5K, 5K, 2K 2D, Rekka or some shit. But I don't really do that much damage on you. If he hits you with a 5K, his damage output, his neutral control, the way he could get damage consistently, his normals just being like out of control strong. You know, that he puts you in plus frames from everything. You have to just guess over and over and over again. It's fucked up. Okay, so yeah. Like, he's really good. You put this character in the hands of, like, a really strong player, and they're, like, bound to do well in tournaments. There's, like, no way around it. Yeah, and he has great mix. He has excellent mix. Amazing mix-ups. His normals? Okay. I mean, his specials? Like, okay. Like, at the ready, steady aim being as plus as it is, the fact that he could make any whiffs safe with just fire and just get, become plus on whiff, like, is fucking stupid. You know, his only weakness is, like, that he has to focus. And even then, like, if you're good, you don't really have to worry about that much. Roll is just a faster fucking, like, you know, cross-up tool. Like you said, it's better than Alpha. You know, it's fucking super hard to deal with. Like, I block it consistently, but, like, it's really hard to punish. It's, like, really hard to deal with. You know, it's really strong. His mix is really good. We can't, you know, there's nothing else to say. He sits pretty in top tier. I think he's the best character in the game. You know, but whatever. He gets amazing wall slump setups. Ridiculous normals. He might 7-3 like the majority of the class. He might 6-4. He might go even with some matchups. He's really fucking really, really dumb. I hope he gets nerfed. So let's move on. Okay, so Nago, right? Nago is like, you know, I'm gonna put him here for now. He's definitely not deep tier. So Nago, okay, remember what we talked about, right? We talked about what makes a character good. What makes a character good, right? And what makes a character good is consistent damage, right? Consistency and control of neutral. That's what my definition of, like, a really strong character, of what makes a character good, is consistent damage and control of neutral. Nago has consistent damage and he controls neutral. I put him also in S tier. He's really, really strong. And the thing is about him is that I feel like, you know, obviously there's a lot of really strong Nagos. I feel like Hotashi is obviously, like, insanely good. I think that, you know, Test Your Luck is really good. There's a lot of strong Nagos. Okay, so Nago has consistent damage from everywhere, right? And his normals and control of neutral are absolutely insane. Okay? Not to mention, he has high health. Okay, and I'm gonna actually, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna put a notepad up. Let's get a notepad going. Nago has, what does he have that's really broken? 2S, a super broken normal. 5H, very, very good. 5K, super good. Okay, Beyblade, super good. Does he have mix? Does he have good mix? He does. He has command grab. That's really fucking annoying to deal with, because then he resets his entire blood meter. Something you always got to be aware of. His 2K is really strong. I mean, it kind of goes without saying, right? People are aware of how annoying this matchup is and how annoying this character is. And the real talk, anybody that says otherwise is capping, bro. Nago carries a little bit. I'm not saying that all Nagos are scrubs. I'm not saying that. But I'm saying that if any character carries really, really hard in this game, it's probably Nago is one of them, because, like, he is a very difficult matchup for a lot of people to learn. Okay? It took me a while to learn it because I was just like, I don't know what to fucking do about blood. And then last patch, finally, I started getting really good at it. I started learning that, okay, if I just react to Fukio, I'm good. I could react to Fukio, 5P Fukio on reaction, and it's over for Nago. Broken round start, controls the top tier round starts. Nago has that. Difficult matchup to learn. Because of that, if, like, imagine guys, could you imagine fighting Nago, like, for the first time, and then having somebody be really, really good with him? You're gonna get cooked, like, 40-0. You're gonna be like, what the fuck? What am I supposed to do? I can't trade. I can't do anything. Right? He's not he's not impossible to beat, but he's fucking super strong. To add to that, he has the highest effective health in the game for some reason. If that's not enough. If that's not enough, he has the highest effective health. Okay? His normals are ridiculous. His mix is ridiculous. Uses BRC super well. 2S is super fucking good. Plus on whiff. Look at They joke right here. But it's not even funny. It's not even funny. He's that strong. Okay? But it's not even... Imagine that. That's not even... This isn't even one of Chip's worst matchup. I'd rather fight Nago than I would Happy Chaos, to be honest. But that doesn't go without saying that this character is fucking really, really strong. Ram is S plus as well. Okay, does Ram have consistent damage from all of her normals? Yes. Does she control neutral? Yes. Does she have a top tier round start? Yes. She has all of this. This is top tier. Okay. She controls a neutral for free. Okay. And the reason she controls a neutral, one of the reasons she controls a neutral like no fucking... Like nobody else, like, I mean, is that her dash speed is too fucking good. Ram needs a fucking dash speed nerf. That would be like one of the best nerfs they could give her. You know, what makes her fucking good? Dash speed, OD. Far slash, OD. 2S. Damage output, you know, 6P is really strong. 5K is super good. So 5K and 2K just beats a lot of normals outright. Insane air footsies, insane air normals. Yeah, you'll get counter hit trying to 6P her consistently. Excellent jump attacks. Excellent, one of the best reversal super in the game. Her matchup spread looks ridiculous. She probably 6-4, 7-3s. Yeah, oh my god, yeah, great point. One of the few abusers of positive bonus. Okay, of peanut butter. She and Chip are like the only ones that get like an infinite, right? Crazy. So she gets that. That was a buff for her this patch. At worst, she might have like 5-5 matchups. At worst. So these three, it goes without question. Super, super strong. Okay? And I want to say, my opinion. This is my opinion. This is where this ends. This is where it ends. No, I know Ram has some 7-3s. She's mad stupid. She's mad dumb. She carries too. That's why she's S plus. These are the carry. This is the I'm carried tier. Leo. Leo is S. He's not S plus. Leo is beatable. However, Leo, does he have consistent damage? Oh, fuck yeah. Does he control neutral? His neutral is really, really good, but there are better neutral games. He has an average neutral game. Okay, average neutral. And I mean this in air quotes, it's average. Because the developers clearly gave him a quote-unquote, like, average neutral game, especially last patch, to balance out that when he's back turned, he's insanely, insanely broken, right? Okay, let's talk about pros and cons real quick. Insane. 2S. Insane. 2K. Let's just list them all in one. Insane 2K. What are his good normals? 2K, 5K, 2D, 5H into guard point. Okay, very good. Very, very good. Back turn, stupid. Stupid, back turn dumb. All right, what else? Unreactable mix. Oh yeah, his 5P has a certain level of active frames that allow you to meaty safe from reversals. Is it 5P or is it 2P? Oh yeah, and then my favorite thing, best DP in the game. All right, so average neutral game, best DP in the game, leads to a fucking 50-50, leads to 50-50. Best offense in the game. Top three, okay, S tier 6P. One of the best 6Ps in the game. Its hitbox is insane. Insane. I can't do mix against him. That's like double jump or triple jump shit with Chip. His 6P, even when he's like way far away, will still counter hit my J2K, or whatever the fuck. It doesn't matter. Insane fireball. Insane fireball. Let's talk about his cons. Even with all of this, even with his insane normals, which are really good, his neutral game is still not as good as the top tiers. Do you know what I'm saying? He has a kind of an average neutral game. And the reason why he has an average neutral game is that he has a committal dash. He actually has to dash. His walk speed is kind of whatever. Okay, unsafe strings, which is what I mean about the Gatlings. 5k into 6k can be IB punished. Same with 2k, which you give his inherent weakness to 2k and 5k in general, because you could IB punish that if you're good. So his because of like his strings, all of his strings are kind of unsafe if he goes from K-Gnarls especially. But he always has to end in either fireball or this move, which is like the basic run through, and all of these are punishable, which give him inherent weakness. And that's why, like, when he's doing that string, you need to pay attention to whether he's going to try to do run through, because they get sneaky. Some Leos like to be sneaky, and they'll do a string into a delayed run through to catch you sleeping. All right, his matchup spread. Unlike the other ones, he actually has more weak matchups, right? He kind of loses to Ram, right? Loses to top characters. Loses to top characters. Loses to Nago for sure. For sure loses to Nago. Okay? Loses to Axel. Probably loses to Happy Chaos too. Even though Leo is like, you know, one of the better characters at fighting Happy Chaos, I still think Happy Chaos wins that matchup. So he loses to Happy Chaos, probably too. Who else does he lose to? So anyway, so my point is, Leo has bad matchups, more than the others, which keep him out of the S tier category, in my opinion. So that's the data. Top 100 characters, I mean, whatever. Okay, so definitely Leo, he's really, really strong. Obviously, insane offense. You could win tournaments with him, no problem. No problem. Is he in the top three? I don't think so. I think he has some weakness that keeps him out, but he's nonetheless stupid, stupid strong. Okay? That's what I think. Let's talk about Sol before I put him anywhere. Yeah, I mean, having bad matchups isn't necessarily, like, you know, a deal breaker, but it definitely affects him. So his good damage depends on counter hit or meter. That's true. But he's still good. I think he's still good. Let's talk about what is good about him. Okay, insane. What are insane normals? Insane 5k. Blessed with a 3-framer. Which makes him able to punish things that he can't. And he could anti-air things that other characters can't. You know, so 5k goaded. 2S. Very good. Very good button. Nobody could disagree. 2S is amazing. F4/ plus on block. Definitely very, very good. I mean, close slash, really good. 2D, really good. 6S, pretty good too. 2K, really good. He has great buttons. Okay? He has great buttons. Great buttons for close range. And the mid range and him being really, really close, it's really good. Far slash does have his weakness though. It kind of loses to like low attacks, right? I'm not really sure even why. I think it's just the way that the hitbox is. But that's why I use a lot of 2K against Sol. Sol kind of gets a little fucked up by that. Okay? But his normals are good. His normals are fucking great. Damage is pretty high. Damage is high. He could two-touch you. Yeah, oh, great defense. Great defense. Insane. He has a fucking Volcanic Viper. Fucking great, great defense. With 5k and his fucking DP. Crazy. He's well-rounded, definitely well-rounded. Scary-ass fucking pressure. Insane pressure, to be honest. Insane offense. Insane offense. But that's kind of where, you know, his pros end. You know, Fafnir is really good, right? Let's talk about his cons. He has some cons. Committal options for block strings, right? One of the problems with Sol is that, like, you have to end in either fucking nothing, you know? So you'll do 5H, which you're minus in. Or you have to end in Fireball, right? You have to end in Gunflame, which could be punished. Because if I FD your first couple hits and then you Gunflame, I get a jump in for free with Chip. I get a JD or a JH. And you get fucking clapped for throwing Gunflame. You could Bandit Revolver. And that's fucking not good for you either. Because I could 6P after the first hit and beat everything you do. Except if you decide to Bandit Revolver and then just go straight into DP, which is risky. So your strings are very committal, not good. No special cancels, no mix without meter. FD removes a lot of pressure and costs nothing to the opponent. No mix without meter, easy to burst. Yeah, like his long range game isn't that good. He has to play footsies with like 6S and 6H, but that gets outclassed by the top tiers, right? His run speed is whatever too, right? And he's a character that you kind of have to get in with him. Yeah, walk back speed being bad. Walk back speed is not great. Those are some serious cons, you know? He does have Fafnir and he's really fucking cool. Look at him. He's a fucking cool ass character. All right, matchup spread. Does he beat HC? Hell no. Loses to top tiers. HC, Nago. Nago cooks him, right? I feel like Nago cooks him. Ram cooks him too. Leo kind of cooks him. I don't know. Oh, Gold Lewis, right? Gold Lewis beats him. I think Gold Lewis beats him. Testament beats Chip. Chip cooks him? You think Chip cooks him? You know what's funny about that matchup is that it used to be so fucking bad for Chip. That matchup used to be like garbage 7-3 matchup for Chip when he used to do like the damage that he used to do. I'm gonna put him into B tier. I feel like he's B tier, guys. Like, he's good. He's not bad. You could win with him. He's not terrible. I think B is pretty fine. B's fair. Everybody loses to the top tiers. You know what I'm saying? High C is pushing it. I think I'm going to remove this row. I don't think there should be that row. I think it's just this. Yeah. His damage output is really high. 5K is a good option to have. Being able to IB and 5K a lot of punishes is pretty... It's pretty good. I think that's solid. And he did win a major. You know? Alright, Kai. Moving on. Where does Kai go? Insane. You already know what the best move in the game is. He has one of the best moves in the game. You guys know where I'm gonna go. Where is it? Oh my god. Oh my god. This move is so fucking good. Holy shit. Okay, he has access to one of the best special moves in the game. The fact that it's 5 frames is fucking great. What a good move. When I'm playing Kai, I'm just like, holy shit, this move is incredible. You feel like you just want to keep using it. The problem with Kai players is that they get so greedy with it. They start using it like crazy because it's just so fucking good, right? Having a move that good puts them a little, you know. So consistent damage. Does he have consistent damage? I think he does. His damage is pretty good. Scum Dipper is good. So Scum Dipper, 5K. What are his good normals? 5K, 2S, Far Slash, 6H. Oh my god, 6H. Underrated button. Underrated. Yeah, he's like average. He has average damage. Average damage. Lack of damage mid-screen. Yeah, without bar. Yeah, that's a good point. So that's what that's his one of his weaknesses. Without bar, he has kind of average damage, which is something like Happy Chaos has. From a 5k, he could do like, what, 5k, 6k, gunshot into a loop, into fucking another gunshot, into potentially super. Lack of consistent, lack of great damage mid-screen. Or without bar, right? Shock state is a pro and a con. He's weak to IB, yeah. Weak to IB. You could IB Dire Claw and fucking own him. Gangster ass fucking air throw. Man, I love hitting this air throw. Don't you love hitting this fucking air throw? You feel like a god when you hit him. He just fucking grabs. Get the fuck out of the air, bitch. I love that shit. I'm gonna put that in pro. Cool air throw. Frame data is kind of whatever. Frame data, whatever. And he's a strike throw character. Strike throw. Strike throw makes him kind of whatever. You could block him out. He doesn't have any crazy mix. Relies on 5D. Stun edge, you know, stun edge is good. It's not bad, but it's not like a fucking Street Fighter fireball. Very plus Oki on knockdown, yeah. Great Oki on knockdown with charge stun edge. Fucking Devil Trigger. Devil Trigger is cool, right? I'm gonna call it Devil Trigger. You guys know what I mean. Oh yeah, reversal super and DP. Raidudo Lightning. Pretty good. Dragon install is pretty solid, underused, you know, makes him broken, but it's just like people don't know how to control the strength. Okay, but his round start is pretty good and he has great control of neutral. Yeah, okay, so yeah, that's the thing about Ride the Lightning. Ride the Lightning hits far. Ride the Lightning goes far, okay? It does, right? Oh, Fudra Arc is fucking good. Fudra Arc is annoying and good. His matchup spread is pretty good. Pretty solid matchup spread. I mean, he probably loses to all the top tiers too, right? Loses to Pot. You know, maybe Gold Lewis. Faust. Don't give me that he loses to Chip. Hell no, he does not. Hell no, he does not. Ram, you know? His matchup chart isn't terrible. He's a character where like your skill really makes a huge difference. Like if you're good with him, I mean, you could cook a lot of people. He's just fair. Kai, damn, look, 50% across the board for the most part. Yeah, loses not to, according to the math, most Kais have a problem with Nago, Gold Lewis, and Happy Chaos. But yeah, it looks like Nago is probably the hardest, huh? Definitely better than Soul. I'm gonna put him in A tier. I think he's pretty good. He has like some losing matchups. He's also kind of hard to play. He's very high skill. High skill character. High skill. Not an easy character. Moving on from Kai. Mei. Where does Mei go? The first thing that comes to mind is that she has fucking great normals. Does she have consistent damage? Yes. Control of neutral? Yeah. She controls neutral. Round start is good. It could be better, but I think it's really good. Cute as a button. Okay. Pro. Cute as a button. Okay. Disjointed normals. Amazing 2S. 5H. 2K. Horrible theme song. Yeah, that's a horrible theme song. And stage. That stage lags. JH. JS. Good air stall. Yeah. Her normals. That all kind of falls in the... I have top tier normals. Command grab, great offense with command with her normals. Her offense is pretty good. Her speed is kind of whatever. Yeah, mid screen she's kind of whatever. Weak to upper body invul. She's still strike throw. Oh my god, 5K, so good. Let's listen to the theme song actually. Hold up 1 second, guys, because I don't remember it. I'm going based on a boy. I trust a boy's judgment. Oh yeah. This is her theme. I guess I wouldn't say it's horrible. I'm gonna take that off. Yeah, no, I like her theme. I actually like her theme. I actually like Bridget's theme too. This is definitely one of the better themes. Yeah, it's not bad. She's just fucking good, dude. Massive damage. High execution with her new thing. High execution for her optimal conversions. She's so good in neutral that people that play her get conditioned to being mashing scrubs. Am I lying here? We don't even have to say it. Her normals are fucking OD, dude. Insanely good normals. Command grab. She's fucking good, dude. Alright. What's her matchup spread look like, though? Dude, I'm gonna say that she's S tier, bro. Call me Cap. I think she's really strong. I just think that a lot of people aren't, like, that good with her. She's either, like, right at the top of A. Let's put her at A for now. I might change my mind. I think she's S tier. I'm gonna put her in S tier, guys. Call me Cap, whatever. Axel. You know, Axel's a character that, like, I swear to you, people love to downplay. I think he's definitely up here, like, in the same tier as Sol. He might, honestly, like, dude, he could win. I don't want to hear that. Oh, no, it's just there's a lot of really strong Axel players. Bro, Axel's make top 8 all day, dude. Axel is B tier. Like, yeah, his player base is really good. You got Remy, that's really good. Stealthy, that's really good. Kanto Kinte, insanely good. You know, Flash was really good when he played him. A lot of people are good with him, and he controls neutral. Control neutral, for sure. He could make you frustrated as fuck. His round start, very good. Very good round start. He has consistent damage. He has everything that makes him a top tier, but he's not. He's not a top tier because he has weakness, right? Oh my god, I guess I was lying. Axel has some of the lowest average damage output in the game. Unless he has meter to spend. Okay, maybe. It's okay damage, but when he hits you with meter, bro, that shit hurts, dude. Or with a slash? I don't know. That motherfucker melts me, dude. Insane zoning. He's pretty good. The problem is it's locked behind meter. Yeah, I guess so. He's kind of like Chip in that aspect, right? He has one of the best normals in the game. With 2K. 2K is top tier. Bar slash is really, really good. 2H is good for what it does. You know? He has great fucking normals. He does have a command grab. It's not that good, but it's okay. His offense is not that great, but it's not bad. Insane. Oh, his jump H is really good. You don't think 2H is that good? It's, I mean, obviously it's punishable. Obviously, if I block it, I'm fucking, you know, you're like negative, you're in a bad situation. But you could hit from so far. It's a big part of his toolkit, right? His close slash is really good. Close slash is OD, right? He has a reversal super. Insanely good anti-airs. Insane anti-airs. Rainwater is really good. He can zone you. He has like all the options. He might be fun to play. He has the best anti-airs in the game. He teaches you how to play super solid because you have to have like really good defense. You know, you can't really like mash like other people. So he conditions you to play in a very solid way, right? So Axel players could switch from Axel and play whatever characters they want at this point, you know, because you gotta be good. Okay, cons. Gets ran over sometimes, right? Committal neutral, yeah. That makes sense. Yeah, long, which means that's the committal neutral, that's long recovery. Yeah, good damage. Locked behind meter. Okay. What are his worst matchups? What are his worst matchups? Tell me his matchups, bro. Let's look at that. Ramlethal, Chip, Milia, and Geo. Those are the worst ones? What about... who does he beat, though? He does beat Nago, right? Stealthy does beat a lot of Chip players, bro. Stealthy has beaten me a ton of times. I've beaten him, too, but he does beat me. He definitely beats Pot. You're smoking, dude. Beats Pot, Faust, Zotto... He has an interesting position in the neutral, in the meta, because like he does beat characters that a lot of characters lose to. Oh, he beats Testament for free, right? He totally fucks up Testament. Okay, so he has a solid matchup chart. Loses to Ram, Chip, but I see Axel players overcome the Chip matchup all day. Emilia is like kind of like, you know, like he definitely loses to HC. While you're here, Diaphone, we'll go to Bridget next. I want to hear your thoughts. He wins against Bridget, beats Bridget. It makes sense. Bridget's kind of like a worse Axel in some ways, but she has a DP and she has skates and she's cute as a butt. So, see, here's the thing. Here's the thing about Axel, guys. It doesn't matter if you lose, you know? It doesn't matter because, like, to beat Axel, you have to be clutch. You gotta be clutch. To beat Axel, you gotta be, like, really, really zen and patient. Because if you're not, he's gonna fuck you up. Like, you gotta be perfect sometimes. You gotta be, like, not tilted at all. If I ever tilt and Chip beats Axel. Chip beats Axel, for sure. You guys get that. But it's the sweatiest winning matchup. Because if I do not play perfect, if I make any mistakes, I might have just lost. You know what I mean? So, like, and that makes Axel a really good tournament character. So that I think is why he does good in tournaments sometimes. Good tournament character. No tilts allowed. No autopiloting allowed. You cannot autopilot not even for a second against Axel. So that boosts him a little bit. All right, so he has an interesting matchup spread. I'm gonna keep him in B tier. I'm gonna be a little controversial. Because we see so many Axels in top eights, bro. We see Stealthy, we see Remy. You know, who else? Who else? The other guy from California, I'm blanking out. Axel's definitely not bottom tier, in my opinion. Trevor, exactly. Trevor Sue, that's what I was thinking of. All right, let's move to the best character in the game. Let's talk about my boy Chip, right over here. Hell yeah, we're talking about Chip. I fucking love this character. Holy shit. Chip is godlike, okay? All right, I'm gonna put him like at the end of S tier or in the big, I don't know where I'm gonna put him yet. Does he have consistent damage? Not really. He gets low damage, but he gets good mix from all of his like conversions. What else does he get? Okay, so let's talk about his pros. Fast as fuck. Okay. Cool as fuck. Great normals. They all have their uses. Far slash is really good. 5K is really good. 2K is really good. 2D is good. 5H is good. J2K is good. JH is good. JS is good. He's fucking, all of his normals have their use. Except for his P normals. Besides 5P. Oh, 5P, the GOAT. Oh my god. Good anti-airs. Good AA. Positive bonus abuser. Great mix. 6K, the GOAT. Uses BRC well. I mean, you guys know he's hard as fuck. Whiff punish machine. Rekka abuse. What are these cons though? Low health. Oof. Dies quick. Super are kind of weak. I mean, their situation, but his supers are not as straightforwardly good as, like, you know, they're like whatever. They're mid. His brother super is kind of whatever. Excellent, great defensive options. Stressful as fuck to play, for sure. He has a kind of bad burst safe routing. Instant consistent damage. Yeah, his hurt boxes are bad. Extended hurt boxes. That's why, like, Far Slash loses a lot. 6H loses a lot. You know, risky offense. Yeah, risky offense. I have to, like, guess on, like, what you're doing. Do you know what I mean? I have to make you condition. Gamma Blade is, you know, risky. Fastest risk buildup. Yeah, you could make him explode in one combo, as it's happened to me many, many times. He doesn't beat anyone in S plus or S, in my opinion, that I've shown so far. He beats Axel. Faust. Pot. GL. I think he beats Eno too, but I suck at that matchup. Gold Lewis, Bucks Gold Lewis. hella hard.
Oh my god. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of it, really. He has, like, a lot of even matchups, you know? That's, I would say, like, cleanly, those are the ones he beats for sure. But he loses a lot, too. He loses to Happy Chaos for sure. Loses to Nago. Loses to Ram. Loses to Leo. Loses to Mei. Viking. Free. Testament. Zato is even. I actually think he loses to Jacko, too. I'm gonna be 100%. But the thing is that, like, okay. So, what I meant, what makes him fun is that he has a lot of volatility. So, with his volatility, right, because he has kind of, like, risky offensive pressure and whatever, you could overcome bad matchups all day, right? High volatility. But because of that, same volatility, you could lose good matchups all day. So volatility is not a great thing. So that makes him like not stable. You know, if that makes sense. Over a lot of volatility. So that's, I'm gonna put him in A. I'm gonna put him in A tier. Okay, what about Bridget? Let's talk Bridget. All right, so Diaphone. Where do you feel Bridget goes to start? What do you think? E tier? She's that bad? No cap. This is serious. We're serious. This is serious. All right. On a good day, she's B tier. Okay. What are the pros of playing Bridget? What are the pros? Let's look at what Dustloop says. If there is anything on her in Dustloop. Which Dustloop is surprisingly super, super well maintained. Low damage. Definite low damage. Holy shit. Low damage. Fucking, she can hit me, Chip, a ton of fucking times. And I'm still alive. I hit her with 1-6-H and it's over. Low damage. Definitely, low health. Oof. Kind of technical character, hard to play. Which I've been listing as a con. Fake disjoints, that's a good way to put it. Fake disjoints. That's why I start using Diaphone. I don't know if you remember when we played in tournament, I was using a lot of 5-H. Cause I just thought like, okay, her buttons are not disjointed. What if I just spam this button? All of your shit, fake disjoints. Big con. Loses to 6P? I didn't even know that. All right. Pros, cute as a button. Cool skates. Screen control, solid screen control. Yeah. Safe offense. Yeah, her theme is great. Her theme is great. Some people don't like it. So, needs orb and neutral. Too much. Loopable pressure, yeah. Safe offense, yeah, loopable. Loopable pressure. Good theme. I think, you know, like, what else? She has, like, solid, her skates are good. Skate movement options are good. Movement is good. Oh, she has a DP. Has a reversal. That's great. Strong movement. Strong mix-up. Mix-ups are good. But her low damage, low health fucking kill her. You need to have orb set up in a very particular way and have like some crazy technical confirm in order to have damage with her. Oh yeah, she has a command grab. Rock the baby. All right, I'm gonna put her, what do you guys think? B tier. All right, Potemkin, consistent damage? Nah, he doesn't. No good damage route. Two piece, oh my god, I'm gonna talk so much shit about Potemkin right now. Control of neutral, he has a good neutral. Round start, not good. All right, let's talk about pros. He's beefy, all right? We all know why you people like playing Potemkin, right? You guys, you get the Potemkin players like feeling like they're playing like a tank or some shit. What are good normals? 2P is good and bad. It like controls neutral, but you get no reward. Oh, 2S is very good. He doesn't have a lot of really good ones that come to mind. 5K is good. JD is good. Yeah, JD. All the pots love JD, dude. They love the butt drop. Close slash is pretty good, but it needs more active frames. I think they need to give it like one more active frame, and then it'll be broken. 6P is good. So his normals are like whatever. Because they have good active frames, but he's whiff punishable. Oh yeah, oh man, absurd damage output. Absurd
damage output. Crazy damage. Megafist is fucking good. Megafist is good. Good health. You know, you could take more risk than a lot of characters. Yeah, your large hitboxes. He could hit from distances other characters can't. Terrifying. The thing says terrifying strike throw mix. Back Megafist, Karabak Megafist, really good. Slido Heddle is really good. Yeah, cons, mobility. His ass. But his defensive options. Oh, Garuda is really good. Garuda. He has some good shit. Defensive options are kind of trash. 5P is awful. Oh my god. His P normals, 5P and 2P are not good. Too slow. My god. He has nothing on defense. Awful defense. Meter reliant. Hard time getting in. You have to be like super patient. You have to have a very, very good ground game. But the thing is that he's exceptionally hard. Like, you have to have such a good ground game. You have to optimize all of his combos to like such a high extent. You're doing Kara, everything. Your fastest punish is like command grab. So his matchup spread is terrible. Who does he beat? He beats Kai. He beats Testament. He beats Kai. You just gotta be good. Like, that's the thing about this game, guys. This is the thing. I'm sorry to tell you guys. This game is about knowledge. It's like homework, the fighting game. You like doing homework? You like being a nerd? Time to learn all your frame data. Time to learn what beats what in every situation, because the people that know, like knowing one thing could sometimes change a matchup drastically. And at the higher levels, matchups that inherently at the beginning seemed impossible start to seem pretty good for you. It happens. Pod has like the worst matchup chart though. I'm sorry to say. He loses to a lot of characters. I'm not gonna waste too much time on him, but yeah, he needs some love. He needs some love. Maybe make him a little easier in some situations with his conversions. We're going to put him in D tier. Okay, Faust. He beats a lot of characters, right? He's like an interesting character in that, like, I'm going to say that he's probably in this same level right here in B tier. He doesn't have consistent damage. Excellent neutral game. He has great neutral games. His walk back speed is very strong for creating like for playing defensive. He walks back so fast. His forward speed is not that fast, but his walking back speed, super fast. Great round start. Very strong round start. 2P beats like almost everything. Good normals, 2P, bar slash, 2H, 5P, 6A, 6P. All of his normals are good. Great normals. Brawl is a unique mechanic. Volatile with items. That's a pro. And a con. You know what I mean? I lost to Papel. In the last time I played Papel in tournament, I lost to him because he literally had the best luck with items I've ever seen. He got like 5 meteors in a row, 2 mini Fausts. I was like, what the fuck is happening? He was just like, meteor, 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 meteor. I was like, what the fuck? It was crazy. So items are both good and bad because just like that, you may get like fucking 3 banana peels or whatever, you know? Low damage. Definitely low damage output. Safe jumps. Good safe jumps. No reversal without meter. No reversal. Yeah. Loses to dash blocking. That's what I started doing. Unusual hurtbox. Yeah. Scary with meter. Yeah. And he could do it. He could win. I think he's pretty solid, honestly. He's not like crazy, but and he has matchups that he does good against. You know why? Because in this meta, he beats Baikin, and that puts him up. Okay, Milia. Let's talk Milia. Off the top of my head, you know, like if I'm not reading anything, fuck, she's fast as fuck. Insane air game with JS and JH and all of her air normals, Capel. Very difficult to play, for sure. Very difficult. I'm going to leave that here. What else? Insane mix with Disc Oki. Okay. Close slash is really good. Good norm, good buttons. Her block strings are not great. We'll get to the negatives. Her normals got better. Good 2K. 2P is good. She has good buttons. A lot of her buttons are good, to be honest. Like, full screen, you know, she has some weak options, but she also has her disc. This move is, like, impossible. It's, like, you can't air to air it. Look at this portion of it is, like, completely disjointed. Her air movement, her air neutral is really strong. Honestly, her biggest thing is that she's, her damage is just not great. Health is bad. No defense. Her defense doesn't have a reversal besides super, right? She's prone to YRC, prone to burst and YRC, true. Strong mix. Looping vortex. I've lost from that vortex from just guessing wrong. I'm gonna put her here. I'm gonna put Pot up here. I don't know if we need two tiers here. Yeah, whatever matchup spread. I know she beats Viking, which is great. Just like Faust does. She also beats, who does she beat? That's like another character unique. She beats Axel, right? Maybe she's like a counterpick character. She could be a niche like counterpick character. She's definitely not good, but she could potentially be better than what the data shows because of her difficulty. She's volatile. Probably very volatile too, just like Chip. Low health warriors. I'm gonna keep her here in B tier. Okay, Zotto. Where's Zotto go? I'm gonna put Zotto over here with Chip. Zotto beats a lot of characters for sure. Water, are you in the chat? I know you love talking about this. He's gonna be the best in A tier, the worst in S tier. He's definitely better than Chip also. He's a little better than Chip. Let's see what makes him good. Best, one of the best users of positive bonus in the game. After you get a wall, after you get like a, what is that, Sun Void in the corner? You're fucked. You're gonna have to block Zotto mix. You know, one of the best users of positive bonus. Great P normals. Fucking steamroll factor. The Dr. Doom of Strive. You know what I'm saying? Like, he could fucking just steamroll you. It doesn't matter if he loses the matchup. He hits you once, it's really good. Oppose is a strong mechanic. Flight is good and bad. Definitely one of the best 6Ps, for sure. Cons, bad, kind of bad defense. Some difficult time against like some of the top tiers. Very volatile, just like Chip. Very volatile. He loses good matchups, and he also wins the bad matchups. Because he could be down, he could get a wake-up grab on Ram, and then get her into set play, get a hit on her, Sun Void, and it's a wrap. So, volatile. It gives him a pro and a con, but it makes him very scary, where like, if you get hit by him, not good. Strong neutral game. His neutral game is very strong. Strong neutral, hard matchup for a lot of people to learn. A lot of people struggle with Zotto. A lot of people struggle with Zotto. I might put Faust here, bros. I don't know. I think Faust might be good. But if Faust is here, Zotto goes here. Do you know what I'm saying? Eddie can control space. He has a fucking assist. Motherfucker has an assist. You could throw Eddie out. And if I hit Eddie, okay, you're still alive. You know, and hard to play. Very technical character. Who does he lose to? Let's see who he loses to. He loses to Happy Chaos for sure. Mei, Ram, maybe Kai, Axel maybe? I don't think he loses to Nago. He used to beat Nago clean. Now it's probably like maybe even. Definitely loses. I could see him losing to Geo. Like that's not a bad matchup spread to lose to. He has a better matchup chart than Chip. You know what I mean? But yet he could still overcome bad matchups in even more of a volatile way. I'm gonna put him in S, bro. I'm sorry, guys. He's won on too many events. He's really, really good. He's a very good tournament character because of like how strong his neutral is and how volatile he could be. All right, Geo. Okay, so pros, great dash, great normals. 2D specifically, 5K is really strong. 2K is really good. Low slash is great. Has an anti-air DP. Like, it's like a 6P. It's like a 6P. Great damage output. I mean, her strike throw is really strong. Besides Chip, maybe best strike throw in the game. her throw, her dash throw is instant. Her super, great supers. What are her cons? Commit heavy strings. Chip could punish. This is why Chip is bad for her. Chip could punish her 5H. Chip could punish all of her options. Her specials got nerfed from last patch. Flip kick is awful now, which means that like there's less mental stack. Yeah, her spiral arrow is good. Okay, consistent damage. She has great damage everywhere. Her control of neutral, it's like hit or miss. But she is really, really fast. I will say that. Her top tier, she doesn't have a top tier round start. It's solid though, because of her dash. Kind of hard to make work at the highest level, because she's so straightforward. Who does she beat? She beats Axel. Gold Lewis, probably. Does she beat any of the top tiers? She loses to Chip for sure. Kai gives her problems, I know. Sol could probably give her problems because you could 5K the Enders. Loses to Happy Chaos, but she's one of the better characters at fighting her. What's the Link the Smuggles matchup list? Yeah, so she loses to the top tiers. Goes even with a lot of characters. He says she goes even with fucking Ram. Wow. Interesting. I mean, that's a good matchup to go even with. Goes even with Axel. Goes even with Bike and solid matchup list. I'm gonna put her over here. All right, we're almost done. Anji. Great RPS system with Fujin. High damage, high health, great normals. Particularly his 2P, his 2S. Those are great, great buttons. Those are the ones that stand out. Cons, punishable RPS system. Honestly, not a lot of people play him at the higher level. Like, also, by the way, if a tier kind of just shows like overall character power. Do you know what I mean? Like, it doesn't mean that Geo's outright better than any of these characters. It just means that they're kind of like in the same area. If that makes sense. So yeah, committal neutral. Powerful Oki, yeah. Oh, he has a reversal frame one. Yeah, high risk. He's a high risk character. That's what I meant by committal neutral. I don't know his matchup spread though. But damn, he does his good damage. And he does well in certain matchups. I wanna say that he's definitely not as bad. This is kind of where I'm thinking of putting him. I wanna put him in B tier. We've seen he could put in work. So he's definitely in that same tier of like, it's possible, you know, unreactable mix, great Oki, unique options with her dash. Stroke is a unique offensive tool. Full screen, chemical love, potential zoning options. Honestly, I was really impressed seeing, Daru at Evo put in all that work. His match with Leffen was very impressive. I loved how he used chemical love and antidepressant skill to kind of zone and play neutral. Reversal super. She doesn't have a reversal super, but she loses to Happy Chaos really bad. She committal movement, which makes her fall prey to like 5P and shit and makes her get zoned easily. That's really her biggest weakness. Throw super. She doesn't have a throw super. Loses to Happy Chaos like Omega bad. It's like losing on character select, to be honest. It's that bad. That's why she's not that good right now, is that she loses to some characters just like Omega hard. Happy Chaos is not great. It's like you either get in or you don't. She can't really play neutral against him, right? But she does good against a lot of other characters. Inconsistent damage, yeah. Her strings are not great either. You know, she used to be like really scary for a lot of people at some point. Some people were calling her top tier at some point. Even Hotashi made a video on fighting her. But I'm gonna put her over here too. I'm gonna put her right here. I think she's fine in B tier. All right, now we're getting to the last characters. All right, Gold Lewis. Guard breaking behemoth typhoons. Crazy neutral with drone. Snowball quickly. Super volatile. Like if you fuck up once against him and you get thrown into the corner, you might lose. Reversal super, great damage, great health. Some characters lose at character select against him. Slow, easy to whiff punish. He's robbery straight up, though. Super robbery character.
I know he loses to Chip, for sure. I mean, he beats Pot, Free. Drone, it goes without saying, Drone is fucking good. Okay? He beats Zotto? Oh, yeah, loses to Geo. Definitely loses to Geo. He Omega beats a lot of characters, though. Let's look at his matchup chart here. Even though, you know, obviously this goes without with a grain of salt. Holy shit, dude. This is just Darkrai. Oh my god. Robbery tier, dude. Robbery tier. Fuck. 67% against Milia. 67% against Anji. 50. Good against Viken. He does beat... I think he does beat Viken. Alright, so he's fucking good. Alright, I don't give a fuck. He's robbery. He robs the fuck out of so many characters. I'm gonna put him here, though. It's either... He's one of those that are, like, potentially S. Jacko. Alright, pros. Cute as a button. Great normals. 2K. Really strong. 2D. Scrubby. What's up, kitty?
What, buddy?
Minions are hard to deal with once they're out. Her cons are definitely her block strings are bad. Until minions are out. So the goal when fighting her is that you really can't let her get minions and set up shop. Because once they're out, that all of her strings become like now like game breaking and dangerous. Yeah, she does have a checkmate win condition with minions. Amazing use of meter. Honestly, very difficult matchup to learn. Kind of like when I talked about Nago and Zotto. Nago and Zotto are hard matchups to learn. Happy Chaos, very hard matchup to learn. Very good mix-up potential. Very technical character. Consistent damage. I think she has consistent damage. She does have control of the neutral game. Her round start is solid, not top tier. But yeah, I would say that she's really strong. I put her up here. I put her either S tier or right up here on the top of A. Honestly, if Zotto could go here, so could she. I'm gonna fucking put her here. Fuck it, dude. Call me Cap. I don't give a fuck. Let's see. Who's left? Viken. Oh my god, Viken, please. Holy shit, dude. Viken, where do we begin? Okay, her theme is good, and her entrance in the game is fucking awesome, too. They made her mad cool. So she's mad cool, I will say. Bro's mad cool. Disjoint, like, bro, her normals are OD, are insane. Bar slash, fucking super good. Her 2S is good. Her 5K is good. Habari is broken. High damage. Unreactable mix set. From throws, great, very strong character. I don't think anybody disagrees. The thing is that Viken is high risk, high reward. You have to be kind of a nut to play her at the highest level. Cons, okay, her movement, average movement. You know, she's RPS heavy. Not like average anti-airs, they're not even weak. People like to say that her 6P is bad or whatever. It's okay, it's serviceable. Oh, JS broken, counter is broken. But she's definitely up here. Her matchup spread, even on this, on the top 100 Vikings, is good. That's a good sign that the character is like strong. Beats Zotto, Leo, Sol, Geo, Mei. Beats a lot of characters. Kind of free. Loses. She definitely loses to Nago. Loses to Gold Lewis. Loses to Happy Chaos. And then she does really good against everyone else. So that makes her good. And then the last character, Testament. Okay, so Testament, mad cool. For sure. Really strong corner pressure. Some of the best. Excellent neutral. Like, super strong neutral. Top tier 6P. Stain is a unique and powerful mechanic. Strong normals. With 2K, bar slash, 6H, 2S. Insanely good round start. So she has consistent damage. Definitely has control of the neutral and has a top tier round start. Okay, so she has the elements of a top tier. Cons, movement isn't great. Besides using like teleports and shit like that, she has kind of a slow movement. No reversals besides super,
which is weak, which is a bad reversal super. Nonetheless, it's a reversal. Hard to master. There aren't many really, really strong testaments, in my opinion, like that are at the highest level besides like Romola. And then there's a couple others. Unsafe pressure without, yeah. But the fireball kind of forces you to be safe. You know what I mean? You have to do like other things to make it more punishable. Fighting Romola made me a believer, for real. Really strong character, underrated. Very underrated. Loses to Potemkin though. Crazy, right? Loses to Axel. Beats a lot of characters, beats Chip. Yeah, this is gonna be taken with a grain of salt because she's still kind of new. Beats Viking, beats a lot of characters, very strong. She's like one of those characters that either like shits on you like really hard or doesn't. So I think she's really strong. I think she's really, really good. I'm gonna put her in A tier probably. A tier or S tier? I'm gonna put her right here. Probably. The best in A tier. But she does have weakness. She doesn't beat everybody like so free, which keeps her out. But she's really good. Or they're really good. So yeah, this is it. This is it, guys. We did it. This is my October 2022 tier list. This is what I think. We did it. We made it all the way to the end. Kind of ordered, but not really. Because I think like everybody in like a tier is equivalent. Do you know what I'm saying?